Afternoon, Art Hostage here, and we're going to do another episode. No, we're not, right? You know, I always say that, right? Now, this is just my little Easter musings, right? You know what I mean? My little thoughts for Easter, right? Because today, right, is the resurrection, right? Or is it tomorrow? Right? I always thought that Jesus got crucified on the Friday, right? And he rose again on the Monday, right? Or was it Sunday? Right, I always get it wrong. Anyway, right, it's a time for renewal, right? And it's just a bit of reflection on things, right? You know what I mean? And happy Passover, happy Easter, and happy Ramadan and all that to everyone around the world and all the Christians, right? They love all this game, don't they? Right, I just want to send this out to my boy, right? And my son, my grandsons, right? His partner and all that, the family, right? Because when he was a little boy, and he used to come over with me, right? He used to stand on the stairs and I'd put this on and we'd sing this together, right? And it's for me, right? It's probably one of the greatest things you can do with your kids, you know what I mean? You know, when you get them into the kids' songs, right? And I just wanted you to listen to it, right? It's quite nice, right? It's only Sunday, isn't it, right? You know, we can put all that serious stuff aside and we can do that tomorrow, right? But just have a listen to this, right? It's Carly Simon, right? Itsy, Bitsy, Spider. Right, and it's a beautiful thing, right? If you've got little young kids, right, and they can stand on the stairs and all sing this together, right? Bit of nice thing, right? Here we go. Well, that was lovely, wasn't it, right? Not bad, was it, for a Sunday, right? It's a nice song, isn't it? Right? That the kids can, you know, you can sing with the kids, right? You know what I mean? You know, we can enjoy those kinds of things, right? Well, I'm going to put another one up, right? That's the nice side, right? The good side, right? Let's have a little look at the dark side, right? Hang on. So, right, we're going to have a little go here, right, with, what's his name? Ron Moody, right? In the film Oliver, right? I love this song, right? I know it's naughty and all that, carry on, but everyone's got a dark side, right? Here we go, right? Have a listen to this one.
Our line of business pays a little better, don't it, boys?
You're all right.
You see, Oliver, in this life, one thing counts in the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. You got to pick a pocket or two, boys. You got to pick a pocket or two.
Let's show everyone how to do it, my dear. Just a game, Oliver. Just a game.
Why should we break our backs stupidly paying tax? Better get some untaxed income. Better pick a pocket or two. You gotta pick a pocket or two, boys. You gotta pick a pocket or two.
Why should we all break our backs?
Robin Hood, what a crook, gave away what he took. Charity's fine, subscribe to mine. Get out and pick a pocket or two. You got to pick a pocket or two, boys. Take a tip from Bill Sykes, he can whip what he likes. I recall he started small, he had to pick a pocket or two. You got to pick a pocket or two. Oh, boys! You got to pick a pocket or two.
We can be like old Bill Sykes, you can pick a pocket or two.
Dear old gent, passing by, something nice takes his eye. Everything's clear, attack the rear. Get in and pick a pocket or two. You gotta pick a pocket or two, boys. You gotta pick a pocket or two. When I see someone rich, both my thumbs start to itch. Only to find some peace of mind, I have to pick a pocket or two. You got to pick a pocket or two.
You got to pick a pocket or two.
Just want some peace of mind. We have to pick a pocket or two.
Put them all back in the box.
Love that. Greatest musical of all time, right? You know what I mean? Right, yeah, I know what you're thinking, right? Well, anyway, right, this is just my little Easter message, right? Well, obviously all that peace around the world and stop killing people and all that game, right? Yeah, of course, we want all that to finish, right? It's not nice, right? Well, Just a little 10-minute one, right? A couple of things. I don't know if they'll let me put this up, right? Because I think you have to do a lot of rabbiting and talking in between recording music or something like that, right? They like you to like drop it in here and there, right? I'm not sure about what all that copyright and all that stuff means, right? Well, but anyway, right? Well, what we got to look forward to, right? Well, we got 6 days till the Tyson Fury Dillian White Heavyweight Championship in London, right? And the clock is ticking on the Kinahan gang, right? In Dubai, and now everyone's starting to jump on the bandwagon, right? The press is starting to be a little bit more courageous, right? And when they're revealing stuff, and I do understand, right? Me, right? I'm not the New York Times. I'm not the Sunday World. I don't have to care, right? I'll just say what I want to say, right? And then lots of times, right? I'm not saying everything I say, right, is 100%, right? Some of it's only 99%, right? But a lot of journalists, they do say to me, here, Paul, right? Here, Turbo. I wish I could just say what I know, right? And all the journalists, right? Nicola Tallant and all that, right? But of course they know stuff, right? That they can't print, right? Because they can't back it up with, like, primary actual evidence, right? But we know it's all true, right? And all the little shenanigans, right? And there's all these psychological games going on. Okay, right now it's coming out that Christy Kinahan, right, he's got the Russian connections and they might flee to Russia and all that carry on. Right, and you see what I've been presenting over the last few weeks, right? It's all starting, it's piecing it together, isn't it? Right, you know, I mean, I know I butcher names. I'm terrible with that, right? I do butcher the names. But it's all coming together, right, with that. And it's going to be a changing of the guard. Right, I've said from day one, right, it's that the super cartel, right, it's going to be dismantled, right, and then it's going to be smashed to smithereens, right, and scattered to the winds, right, to quote Sam Halpin, right, who said JFK said that, right, and then what'll happen, right, is like lots of little groups to start, right, and we'll go back to the old time, right, well, instead of having sort of like, I don't know what you got, you know, 50 groups, main groups, right? It might split into 100, 150 or something. I don't know, right? But there's lots of little groups jockeying a position, right? Because they all want their little slice, right? And I've given you my side of it, of what people tell me, right? And then we're going to get back to the art crime, right, next week as well, right? I haven't forgot about that. I've got loads of episodes to do, right? I've forgotten how many I've got to do, loads of them, right? And we've got a little bit away from that in the last sort of couple of weeks. We've been sidetracked, right, with this Kinahan thing, right? Well, and you know my pathway into this was Rafael Imperiali, right? When he got arrested and extradited, he's now in Italy, and he bought the Van Goghs that were stolen by Octave Durham, right? And then we can get back onto Arthur Brand and Chris Marinello and Anthony Amore and all them, right? Because we've got lots coming up. Right, and as I say, brace yourself, right? The message is something big's happening, right, in the art crime world, right? And stay tuned for further details, right? But anyway, there's my Sunday musings, right? And what else is going on? There's quite a few things going on, right, that I can't talk about just yet, right? But more will be coming forward. Right, and we should see what's happening, right? And then in a few weeks' time, right, we've got Hitler's horses, right, them monumental bronze sculptures of horses that stood outside the Chancery in Berlin, right, outside Hitler's office, right, they're coming out of storage in May, right, and they're going to be taken to Berlin, right, to the Citadel Museum at Spandau, right, in Berlin, right, and as I said before, right, I hope they cover them up when they take them there, right, and once they get into the Citadel, right, they've had to reinforce the floor so they can handle the weight, right, and that's a banana skin, right, that's an accident waiting to happen, right, because neo-Nazis are going to use, right, the public display of Hitler's horses, right, as a shrine to Hitler and the Third Reich, and with all what's going on in the world, right, I don't know, it just seems worse than bad taste, right? It's like pouring gasoline on the fire, right? The rise of the fascists and the right and all that carry on. So anyway, there's a few things coming up, right? And so we'll sort of pick it up again tomorrow, So this is like a little 15-minute one, right? And I hope that you liked it, right? And I didn't want to get a bit I know I got a bit sentimental at the beginning, right? But I think that, you know, parents, right, they like singing a song with their kids, right? And for me, right, it was always Itsy Bitsy Spider, right? Nice little thing. And that, and you can use that as a metaphor, right, as for what's going on in the world. You know, that all of a sudden the spider, you know, the rain comes down, right, which is law enforcement, washing out the spider who's nasty. Then the sun comes out and everyone has a little break, right, but then the Itsy Bitsy Spider reappears. Might not be as big as the one before, right, but it might be a lot of little ones. But anyway, Art Hostage, right, signing off, Easter Musings, we call it episode 63, right, episode Easter Musings 2022, right, and we'll speak again very shortly. Art Hostage signing off.